Hi guys, my name is Greenoid, Gemzicle, and welcome to episode 7 of Mean Girls Sorority Year. Guess what? Something super exciting. I've got gems. I've been asking you about whether I should get gems or not, and I've got a ton. The lovely people over at Pocket Gems were very kind. I think I said in last week's episode, or last episode, it wasn't last week, was it, when I uploaded, but last episode, that I was going to try and contact them and see if they would send me some gems so I can show you some of the options on the gem options, because you know we've been moaning about that quite a lot, and they so kindly sent me some over, so that is so fantastic. So I'm super excited about this episode, but something seems to be going on, that like something not quite good here, but who cares, because I have loads of gems and I can show you some awesome stuff. So let's get started. Amy, Louisa, you two had the lowest bids from the auction. Just give me one more chance. I'll donate the money myself. Amy, you know that's not how it works. I'm sorry, but you two are out. Bye. So harsh. I really don't like this. Aww. Huh. Who would have thought Borsha could pull more in more books than a laser hair removal heiress? I know. Borsha's like poor. Look at Borsha in the background. Congratulations, girls. As we approach the final round of cuts, we thought we'd play a game that's a long-standing Rush Week tradition here at Delta Mu Tau. It's called Sister Secrets. We go around the room, and as you may have guessed by the name, everyone shares a secret. It's the next step towards the lifelong bond you're all forming, and if you make one up, we'll know. Ooh, exactly the kind of juicy details my story needs. Okay, does anybody want to go first? I'll go! This one's been weighing on me. Ladies, my fellow pledges, sometimes in the cafeteria, I choose toaster waffles instead of the strudel. My goodness. They're just so golden and brown and delicious. I'm like, oh my god. Thank you. You've given me the courage to be brave. Tamara doesn't look so impressed with that one. Oh, Dakota. Oh, that's her name. I've been talking about her, thinking that she's going to get the cut. Her name's Dakota. I'll go next, if no one else wants to. I hate my mum's new husband. I haven't told anybody because he makes my mum really happy. But honestly, sometimes I hope they get divorced so I can have my mum back. Aww. As we went around the room, I couldn't help but feel really close to these girls. Some of them revealed real vulnerabilities. I hit a parked car in front of the dorm on move-in day. Snapped off the mirror and dented the door pretty bad. But I just panicked and drove away. I wore my grandmother's antique necklace to a party and lost it. Then I lied to my grandma and told her somebody stole it. Janis dazzled us with an elaborate work of fiction. And there it was, right underneath my uncle's barn. A nuclear missile. My goodness, what story is she telling? Of course, the army swore me and my family to secrecy, but we're about to be sisters, so I feel safe telling you. Regina went straight for the heartstrings. I cheated on my boyfriend, Aaron, in high school. He was so nice, so sweet. He didn't deserve that. I was just so conflicted, you know. My heart was wrenching me in two different directions. It was so hard. Oh, look at that. Thank you. Thank you for being there for me, all of you. what secret are we going to tell? And then, of course, it was my turn. Greenoid, you're the last up. I'm just thinking in real life, what secret would I tell? I don't know. Actually, I know what secret I would tell. But I'm not going to tell you, obviously, because it's my secret. Last year, I wanted to get into Yale so badly. I used my boyfriend's phone to text his dad and asked him to recommend my friend Greenoid. Ah, good times. Do you remember that? Back in the day, mean girl senior year. Thank you for all being so open and honest with us. I know this was hard, but it proves just how much you respect sisterhood. I really love all of you. And the thing was, we could all feel it. Oh, that's nice. These worlds were these girls were great, and it was a moment that did mean a lot. I understood what Michelle meant. I loved them too. Michelle, how about you? Anything to get off your chest? Me? This game isn't about us, Tamara. Why don't you tell the girls what our next event will be? Okay, pledges, listen up. There's one more cut event to get through. It's our annual tea party with Major Delta Mu, Tau, alumni in attendance. This is a formal tea, ladies, so remember, you'll be judged by your etiquette, grace and integrity. Guess that rules out Regina. There's that scowl that she has. And of course, your confidence. And that puts her right back in. There's that kiss. There's no way Mika will come to this. Not after what happened with the charity auction. Do we all need to bring a date tomorrow? What do you think? That would be a yes, Greenoid. All of you need to come to the formal tea with an escort. No exceptions. Uh-oh. Mika will do it for us, I'm pretty sure. We could go with Cam. No, that just wouldn't go well, would it, at all. That's a bad idea. Oh, here he is. Let's see. Hey, I was hoping I'd catch you before class. Hey, have you heard from the film programme yet? I made it in. Congrats! Thank you. How's he been? Has he been a bit off? I think maybe he's been off. Okay, you're still mad. I know I wasn't totally transparent. Totally transparent? You lied to my face. I think you're blowing this out of proportion. Why didn't you just tell me about the auction when I asked? Because I thought you'd freak out. I know you weren't trying to hurt me. I'm still so paranoid from everything my ex put me through, and that's not fair to you. How about we go on a real date tonight? Just you and me. We don't have to talk about film school or Rush or how petty I've been acting. Just a good old-fashioned candlelit dinner between boyfriend and girlfriend. Actually, there's this thing I have to do tonight, and I was hoping you'd come with me. What kind of thing? A formal tea at Delta Mu Tau? It's the last big event before they make final selections. I'm more of a coffee drinker myself. Come on, there'll be free food, and you'll get to meet the other girls in my Rush class. I'll pass. Oh no, we can't pass. Mika, please. We have to bring a date. It's the rules. If you don't come with me, it might hurt my chances of getting in. Would that really be such a bad thing? Are you serious right now? I'm just saying, Delta Mu Tau has some pretty weird rules. Fine, you're right. Clearly you don't think so because now you're mad at me. I'm mad at you because you're acting like a brat, Mika. Ooh. And it's not bratty to choose a silly tea party over dinner with your boyfriend. Sorry if I don't want to spend my night standing around whilst you try to impress a bunch of sorority idiots. Uh-oh. Things ain't going well with Mika, are they, at all? Never mind. I'll find someone else to go with me. This is not good, because we're going to go with Cam. Oh, no. God, would you slow down with the texting? I'm getting seasick just watching you. I can't show up to a party without a date. Who can I try? What about Damian? Maybe he'll actually read one of your texts. I'd be surprised if he even remembers what I look like. Seriously? I figured you guys would go together. That'd require him having time for something besides his stupid frat. Anyway, it's fine. I can take Sad Thad, the lovesick lad. I like that your mean nicknames rhyme now. It's a gift. Anyway, that guy would swallow broken glass if I told him to. As long as Kevin G doesn't find out, I don't mind doing you a solid. You're the best. Oh, Greenoid! I think you're, well, not the best, but certainly the mediumest. Don't you knock. This is my room too. Do you guys know what you're wearing to the tea yet? Tamara sent out an email saying she wants us in dresses with floral motifs. This is when we're going to get to use our gems, I think. Yikes, I was just about to try some options on. Yay, fashion show! Okay, garden party, let's see. Oh, that's nice. I like to see the options, even though we're not going to try them. Let's just have a little look at them. Sweet and sassy. Ooh, nice. I don't think so. Okay. Fabulous florals. Oh, I mean, that's not the nicest, but if she wants us in florals, that's what we shall wear. Okay, so I mean, I think the other clothes were both nicer, but she wants us in florals, so we're gonna wear floral. This is costing 18 gems. Yay, we finally get to use our gems. Use 18 gems, yes please. For purchasing fabulous florals, you've also unlocked the outfit Sweet and Sassy and Garden Party in your closet. Oh, awesome. That's cool. I didn't even know, can we get changed in this? Like, I didn't even know that that was a thing that we could do. Anyway, you look super pretty. Like, way better than me. I dig it. Yay, let's pick Janice's outfit next. I'm wearing this. On purpose? Wait, are you skipping the tea party to, like, paint a barn or something? This is a nice dress. If you think so. It really is a nice dress, it's just not very floral, is it? Not that it matters what I wear. Why not? Greenoid, this is me we're talking about. Janis Ian isn't sorority girl material. This'll be the last time I set foot on Delta Mu Tau soil. I wish I cared as little as you do. But Delta Mu Tau means more to me than ever. And tonight I find out if I get in. Ooh, yeah, that's the end. So I think maybe in next episode we'll hopefully find out if we're in. Hopefully that floral dress is going to help us, but we shall just wait and see. But thank you so much for watching this episode. Go ahead and give a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you are new to the channel. And I will see you guys soon for a new video. Bye.